Jesus said, I am with you always. What a wonderful promise that you and I have. If Jesus is for us, who can be against us? In Colossians 1, verse 16, it says like this, all things are created that are in heavens and that are on earth, by him, through him, and for him. Created by him, through him, and for him. If the Creator is with us, who can be against us? In this promise, you and I can have confidence that in the most difficult period that we are going through, God is with us and he will help us. Amen. Amen. So in this lockdown period, we do life differently. All of us do life differently. Some of the things that we have not practiced in the past has become a lifestyle. Some of the habits that we have never practiced have become a habit. We are at home, maintaining a social distance, especially when we go out to buy things, the basic essential things. We go out with the protective gears of mask, gloves, we carry the 60% alcohol hand sanitizer, and when we come back home, we wash our hands in a different way that we have not practiced in the past, and we wash our clothes. All these things we are doing because out there we believe coronavirus may be there. The consciousness of coronavirus have altered our life drastically. Now my question to all of us this today is, how much more we should be having the consciousness of God's presence with us, especially when he promised in Matthew 28 verse 20, I am with you always. I am with you always, even to the very end of this age. How much more we should be conscious of having God's presence in our life. If we are aware of God's presence, and if we practice God's presence, and if we alter our life based on God's presence, our life will be different and we'll be blessed by it. Now let me read a couple of scriptures how we can live our life in this lockdown period. We still have a few more days. I still don't know the exact number of days, how long we'll be at home completely. But whatever the remaining days that we have during this lockdown period, let us all practice of God's presence in our life. To begin with, I want to read Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6. Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6. Now, Hebrews 11 verse 6, it says, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. But without faith, it is impossible to please him. Now, God's presence is there with us. But how can we experience that presence? It is through faith. It is something like our faith will please him. Our faith will welcome his presence, manifested presence in our life. Faith will please him. What is faith? We can see the definition in verse 1. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, evidence of things not seen. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, evidence of things not seen. So we may not have any evidence of God's presence in our life, but by faith we come to him. But by faith we believe that he is there with us. So now coronavirus may not be there outside in our area, but still we wear our mask, protect ourselves with lot of gears, just in case. What if it is there? We want to protect ourselves. We want to protect our family. We don't want to catch anything from any carriers, or we don't want to be the carrier. So we're protecting ourselves. We have not seen it, but we are believing it. It can be there. It may be there. So we have altered our lifestyle. Now coronavirus may not be there, with you at this moment, but Jesus is there with you at this moment. So how much more we should practice His presence right now in our life. We should change certain things, how we have changed for coronavirus. Similarly, we have to do our life based on the promise that He has given us, that He will never leave us nor forsake us. Now, let's go to verse 6. Now, without faith, it is impossible to please Him, for he who comes to God must believe that He is. He who comes to God must believe that He is. Belief is something like we are for sure He is with us. You know, Jesus said in prayer also, when you pray, believe that you have already received it and then you will have it. So he's saying the same principle, you know, in this passage, that we should believe He is there and we can have His presence in our life. And it goes like this. And God is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. God is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. If we diligently seek God, we will experience God's reward, His presence. So out in the world, you see many people, sometimes they walk carelessly. They are not bothered about the coronavirus threat. So they are careless. They don't believe. Okay, so they don't wear masks, they just walk and come back thinking that nothing can happen to them. Now, those are the vulnerable people and they can catch coronavirus. God forbid, they can catch. So we should be careful of how we do life like that. But I want to tell you in this moment right now, the kingdom of God doesn't operate in the carelessness. The kingdom of God doesn't function in carelessness. The kingdom of God rewards diligence. A diligent mind, a diligent heart, a diligent hand will find the reward of the things that we are doing. Especially in the matter of the faith, a diligent heart. Diligently we are seeking Him and we will experience God's reward in our life. Amen. Bible talks about faith in this way. Whatever is not of faith is sin. That means whatever things that I do doesn't have faith in that. If I do things without faith, eat without faith, sleep without faith, work without faith, cook without faith, swabbing without faith, that all can be sin unto us. That's what Bible talks about. So whatever things that we do, we will do it diligently, knowing that we are doing unto the Lord, knowing that we are having God's presence with us. So when we do like that, God said He will reward us. Now there's a story in the Bible, Cain and Abel. Cain was the tiller of the ground. Probably he was a farmer or a gardener, we don't know. But he was working on the soil, doing hard work. And then Abel was the shepherd. He was handling the sheep. He was out in the sun, watching the sheep, taking care of the sheep. And the day came, they both brought an offering to the Lord. Cain brought the fruits and Abel brought the lamb. Abel's offering was accepted. Cain's offering was not accepted. The reason? Why? Because Bible says Abel offered a better sacrifice because of faith. He believed, number one. Faith pleased him, number two. And probably he diligently came to serve the Lord through his offering. When Cain was rejected and he was angry at the Lord and his countenance fell. Now God talks to Cain like this. Now Cain, why are you angry? Cain, why are you angry? Verse 6, Genesis chapter 4, verse 6. Cain, why are you angry and why has your countenance fallen? If you do well, will you not be accepted? And if you do not do well, sin lies at the door and its desire is for you. You should rule over it. You should rule over it. So God was helping Cain, even though he did not please God, okay, because faith pleases God, even though it did not please him, see the goodness of God. Sometimes our character, our attitude, it may not please him, but the goodness of God comes over us and helps us to do well in life. Similarly, God has not given up on Cain. He's coming to Cain. Cain, you didn't do well, but you couldn't do better. I want to help you to do well. So that's what God is telling us. In the lockdown period, if you're doing well, praise God for it. If you're not doing well, I believe God is coming and knocking at our doors, knocking at our hearts. Son, daughter, do well. Have faith. I am with you. Don't live in fear. Don't live a life without hope. Don't live in anxiety of not knowing what the future lies ahead. Trust in me. I am the creator. I have created everything. I have created you. I know the times. I have gone ahead of you. I know the path. I know the way. Follow me. That is what Jesus is telling us in this lockdown period. So what you and I have to do is do well, believing in him, trusting in him, having faith in him, coming to him diligently, and that will please the Lord, and that will help us to have the reward from God, his very own presence in our life. His presence will satisfy all our needs. His presence will satisfy all our needs. Sometimes our needs will be satisfied by the things that we may have, but when you don't have those things, his very presence can satisfy the needs that we don't have also in our life. Satisfy our life, even though we may not have many things in our life. Because what you and I need is, it is the presence of God in our life. And if we have it, we will experience hope, we will experience faith, and we will experience love. We will experience hope, we will experience faith, we will experience love. And our lifestyle will be of these three characteristics: hope, faith, and love. Hope, faith, and love. These three things will be there in our life. When people see us having these three things in our life, of course, peace, I'm talking about, they will see us, and for sure they know God is real. Today, you and I have not seen coronavirus, but we have seen the effects of coronavirus. We have seen it affects people. We have seen the results of coronavirus. It makes some people to die. So when we live a life of practicing God's presence out there, people in the world will know the peace that we have, will know the hope that we have, will know the faith that we have, and will experience the love that we experience from God when we love one another. And they will believe in the risen Savior Jesus. That's how you and I can live in this lockdown period. So God was for Cain. He was for Abel, and he was for Cain. And he was helping Cain. Cain, you can do well. Sin is at the door, but you can master it. So sometimes the temptation can be there outside of our life. But Jesus is telling, I know you have fallen down. I know you're not done well. But I want to help you. Come, let's do it together. Let's do things well. I am with you. So let's do it together. So that is how Jesus is helping in this lockdown period. And that is how we can experience God's presence in our life. So now, practicing God's presence, number one, we should believe that he is there. We should have faith in him. And apart from these things, we can do all other things. Our prayer talks about practicing God's presence in our life. We commune with him daily. Not daily means at a particular period of time. We commune with him continuously. We read the Bible. We meditate upon the word of God. We praise and honor him through our words. So when you do all these things, what we are doing, we are pleasing him through our faith. When we do these things, I believe God's presence will manifest. We will experience God's goodness over our life. Amen. So with this, I will wind up this message. God bless you all. God is for us. If God is for us, who can be against us? Amen. God bless you.